All right, we're going to solve and check some more problems that contain grouping symbols like parentheses. So here's a problem. Solve and check 4 times the quantity 1 minus 3x is equal to 9 minus 7x. All right, on the left-hand side I have parentheses, so I need to do the distributive property. 4 times 1 and 4 times the 3x. So that'll give me 4 minus 12x equals 9 minus 7x. Right, now I've got variables and constants on both sides of the equation, so I could put the variables on the left side or the right-hand side of the equation. I'm going to go ahead and just put them on the right-hand side of the equation. The reason I'm doing that is it'll be a positive number in front of x. So if I go ahead and add 12x to both sides, notice that I'm going to get a plus 5x. So I'm going to have a plus 5x on this side, right? Also, would like to get rid of this 9, so how about subtracting 9 from both sides? So I have 4 minus 9 on that side. On the left side, I'll have negative 5 equals 5x. And then I can divide both sides by 5 so that I get negative 1 equals x. Basically, that's saying x is negative 1, right? X is negative 1 is the way we usually like to write that. So it looks like our solution set is going to be negative 1. Now we want to make sure that's correct. So we go ahead and plug in negative 1 every place we see x in the original equation, and we're going to use the order of operations to simplify. So I have 1 minus 3 times a negative 1. Let's just do one side at a time. Let's do the left-hand side. So we've got 4, and inside the parentheses we need to simplify. That's 1. I have minus 3 times negative 1. That's plus 3. Still simplifying inside the parentheses. That's 4 times 4, or 16 on the left-hand side of the equation when you plug in negative 1. Now let's do the right-hand side. 9 minus 7 times a negative 1. And again, you need to do order of operations, so you have to do the 7 times negative 1, right? You don't do 9 minus 7. So I have a minus 7 times negative 1, that'll be a plus 7, which is 16. So I got the same number on both sides, so I guess I did this problem correctly. I just love algebra. We can check our answers. How about putting this video on pause and you trying this problem on your own? See if you could solve the problem and then check it. See? All right. So we've got parentheses again on the right-hand side. On the left side, it is simplified because I'd have just constant and a variable part. I mean, a constant term and a variable term. So I can copy that down again. But on the right-hand side, we need to distribute just the minus sign. Now remember, you could think of this as plus and negative 1, or when you distribute just a minus sign, it just changes the signs. That's how to remove parentheses. So we have a minus 6x and a minus 7. Now the right-hand side is still not simplified because I have two constants over there, right? A 12 and a negative 7. So I need to simplify that by writing the 12 minus 7 is 5 minus 6x. Now I could have written that as negative 6x plus 5 just as well. It's up to you. All right, so now we're ready to get the variables on one side and constants on the other. So let's add 6x to both sides, so that we don't have any variables on the right. So the variables are going to be on the left, right? Negative 5x plus 6x will be x, which means I need to get rid of this negative 9, I mean this positive 9. So I'm going to subtract 9 from both sides. So 5 minus 9 is negative 4. All right, so it looks like negative 4 is going to be the solution if I didn't make any mistakes. The only way I know whether I made a mistake or not is to, well, I could redo the problem over and over again, check in the back of the book, go ask somebody else, or you don't have any of those options on a test, really, so we're going to just plug in negative 4 for x. So I have 5 times a negative 4. Let's do the left side first. So remember, you do this multiplication first, the negative 5 and the negative 4. You do not do 9 minus 5. So I've got 9. This is going to end up being a plus 20, which is 29. Now we've simplified the left side as much as possible. We evaluated to get 29. Let's see what the right side is. So we have 12 minus 6 times negative 4. So I'm going to put just times the negative 4 plus 7. And we're going to do inside parentheses. Don't use the distributive property when you check. Here's the reason. Let's say you made a mistake on the distributive property when you solve the equation. You're likely to make the same mistake using the distributive property when you check, so you're not really checking very well. So I like to use a different method when we check. So we have 6 times negative 4, negative 24 plus 7, because remember, I have to simplify inside the parentheses. So I have 12 minus. Now, what's a negative 24 plus 7? That's a negative 17, because I'm adding a negative and a positive, so negatives outweigh the positives, subtract. And 12 minus negative 17 is 12 plus 17, which is 29. Woo! Yay! We did get the right answer of negative 4. Now, if you get the wrong answer over here, it's so hard to find your mistake, I suggest you just erase it all and start from the beginning, solving your equation. It's really hard to find your own mistakes. But you give it to somebody else and they see it right away. It could just drive you crazy. All right, let's try a different one. All right, how about putting the video on pause and trying this one on your own? I'm going to give you a little hint. You're going to get a fraction. Remember, that doesn't mean you're wrong if you get a fraction. So go ahead and try that. All right, now I'm going to do it. So the right-hand side simplified, but the left-hand side, I have parentheses again, so I'm going to have to distribute my minus sign. So I have 7 minus 5 plus 8x. Remember, to distribute your minus sign, it's going to change the signs of everything inside the parentheses. So instead of plus 5, you have a minus 5. Instead of a minus 8x, you'll have a plus 8x. And then on the right-hand side, I just copy the problem down. The left side is still not simplified because I have to combine the 7 minus 5. Those are the constants or the like terms in this case. So I have 2 plus 8x equals 4x plus 3. All right, now we're down to at least both sides being simplified. So now we want to solve for x. So we need to get the variables on one side, constants on the other. How about subtracting 4x from both sides so that the variables are on the left-hand side? That'll give me the 4x. And that means I'd like to get rid of this plus 2. How about subtracting 2 from both sides? So 3 minus 2 is 1. And like I said, you're going to get a fraction because when I divide by 4, that's what happens. So the solution here looks like it's 1/4, right? And don't freak out, you could do this. Now we're going to check it. 7 minus 5 minus 8 times 1/4. We're plugging in 1/4 for x. All right, let's do the left-hand side here. We have to do inside parentheses, so I copy to the parentheses. Now, minus 8 times 1/4. Well, 1/4 of 8 is 2, right? Because the 4 goes into the 8 twice. So I've got 7 minus, well, inside the parentheses, 5 minus 2 is 3. So that's going to give me 4. Hey, that's kind of cool. When I checked it, at least I didn't get a fraction. Now let's do the right-hand side. 4 times 1/4 plus 3. Well, 4 times 1/4 is 1. And 1 plus 3 is 4. Hey, not so bad. Got the same number on both sides. So 1/4 is the solution. I don't think I'll have time to solve and check this, but let's see if we could do this big long problem, at least solve it. Why don't you try it first on your own by putting the video on pause? Well, one nice thing, the right-hand side simplified, but what about over here on the left? We have two grouping symbols, both parentheses and brackets, so I need to do the innermost parentheses first. So I copy up to there, and I need to do the distributive property right here, with a negative 2 times 2x minus 3. So I have negative 2 times 2x is minus 4x, and negative 2 times negative 3 is plus 6. I've distributed here, and I need to put my grouping symbol of the bracket. And finish writing the problem. Now I can simplify within the brackets. So I have x minus 4x. Remember that means 1x minus 4x. So that's negative 3x plus 6 plus 1 equals 2x minus 3. And now these grouping symbols can be written as with parentheses. You distribute 12x minus 24 plus 1 is 2x minus 3. Getting there. 12x minus 23 is 2x minus 3. You should get 10x equals 20. X is 2. I'm running out of time. I didn't show every single step, but hopefully you got it. There we go.